Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Jaspreet Kaur and today we will study the module Tribal Areas and Crafts from the paper Indian Anthropology. The learning objectives of this module are to know about different tribal areas of India, understand the importance of Indian tribal art and craft, know about various types of tribal crafts of India, to know about the role of government and non-governmental organizations in promoting tribal art and craft industry. With the advancement of technology, the increasing pace of urbanization and industrialization, where majority of rural population is moving towards urban world, there is a threat to the local culture-based industries, which plays an important role in building the economy of a nation. Often these art and culture sector, which is the foundation of these industries, is neglected and not recognized as a contribution in national economy. But as globalization is taking a pace, the art and craft of Indian tribal communities is given recognition at the national level rather than at the international level. There are several government and non-government organizations that bring the art and craft culture of various tribal communities to a platform where more and more people could come across it. In such a way so that the manufacturers get the deserving amount in return and also recognized at national and international level. India has become one of the preferable tourist spots in the globe, so millions of foreigners visit India every year. And one of their favorite souvenirs is any handmade object, especially which depicts a story or a part of any culture. Handmade objects demand continuous hard work and patience, and the hard work is reflected from the final piece. This is the reason behind the growing demand of tribal crafts in India. For the economic development of tribal people, the Government of India has set up an organization, the Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India Limited. This organization provides market support to the tribal population of India, which constitutes around 8% of its total population. This organization not only helps tribal people to promote their products at domestic level, but also at the international level. Various workshops and seminars are organized where tribal people can express themselves in the form of these artifacts. Tribal areas of India. Now, the tribal population of India constitutes around 8% of the total population of the nation. The Statistics Division of the Ministry of Tribal Affairs keeps a record on the tribal population of the nation. And in 2013, the statistical profile of scheduled tribes in India was prepared under the supervision of Ministry of Tribal Affairs. According to this profile, it is depicted that the number of scheduled tribes is 705. But according to the Census of India 2011, the total tribal population is around 10.43 crores, and out of this, around 89% live in rural areas and only 10.3% live in urban areas. The tribal population of India is distributed among various states and UTs of India, but majorly the STs are concentrated in two areas in India. These two geographical areas are the central India and northeastern India. Out of these two areas, more tribal population is inhabited in central India, which is clearly visible in the map. In central India, the tribal population is distributed mainly in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Gujarat, Maharashtra and Rajasthan. In the northeast part of India, the tribal areas are situated in the states of Assam, Mizoram, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipur, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. It is also seen that the tribal population of India is distributed in the states of Madhya Pradesh, Odisha, Maharashtra, Gujarat, Jharkhand, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh, but in Delhi NCR, Haryana and Punjab and the UTs of Puducherry and Chandigarh, these are the states that have no ST populations. The Census of India 2011 also released data on the tribal areas of the country, and according to this, the states of Mizoram has the highest tribal population and the states of Uttar Pradesh has the lowest tribal population. The tribal population in India is spread across the diverse land of the country. Although all tribal communities have been brought under the category of scheduled tribes on the basis of certain common characteristics, but each and every ST has its own unique characteristic features which give it an identity. Each tribe has a unique culture and tradition, and these cultural traits can be observed from the artifacts that they produce. The types of Indian tribal crafts. Tribal crafts include any handmade artifact prepared by tribal people. These products are generally made by raw material which is procured from the nearby forest or any natural resources. These products have unique pattern and designs on them, and that is why these days tribal crafts is gathering very much attention all across the globe. Different tribal populations in India inhabit different geographical areas, so there is a difference in the environment any tribal community in India is exposed to. In India, around 89% of the tribal population lives in rural areas where they are in close contact with the forest. These forests play a very crucial and important role in the lives of any tribal community. Most of their daily use products are procured from these forests, and tribal people depend on them for fruits, vegetables, wood, leaves, and much more. Apart from these daily needs, there are several other products which forest blesses these tribal communities with. A tribal population inhabiting near bamboo forest is highly efficient in making several bamboo items. These items not only help them in their daily routine, but also they have become very popular in national and international markets, where people buy many of the tribal crafts as showpieces and use them as gift items. These crafts differ from one tribe to another and depend only upon the availability of raw material. Some of the very famous and exquisite Indian tribal crafts include the metal crafts, tribal textiles, tribal paintings, tribal jewelry, cane and bamboo products, and pottery. Now let us discuss these types of Indian tribal crafts one by one. The first ones are the metal crafts. The tribal artisans of Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Orissa, and West Bengal are famous for their metal crafts. The metal products produced in these regions of nations come under the bell metal art or Dhokra art. This art is most famous in the Bastar and Raigarh district of Chhattisgarh, where golden colored objects are made out of bell metal, bronze, and brass. The Dhokra art derived its name from the Dhokra Damar tribe, who used to lost wax techniques for making of these products. There are mainly two techniques which are used in making these metal products, and these are the lost wax technique and the iron smithy technique. So there are two types of techniques that are used in making the metal products. Let us discuss these one by one. The first is the lost wax technique, which is used by the Gharwas of Bastar and Jharwas of Rajgarh. These tribes practice this technique to make metal products. The Malars, the Bharewas, and the Savarkar tribal artisans also use this technique. In this technique, a clay core with wax ribbons is used to make patterns, and then this pattern is coated with clay. Then this is followed by melting, and in this process of melting, the wax melts off and a cavity is formed. This cavity is now filled with molten metal. After some time, this molten metal solidifies and the structure formed is brought out after breaking off the clay shell very carefully. This is now given the final finish by hands of the craftsman. The wax used in this technique is either the bee wax or the resin obtained from the sal trees. The process of this technique shows how this tribal people have incorporated natural products like the resin or the bee wax with the metal and fire and have come up with such a great outcome. This technique is used to create items which are of daily use, like the lampstands, hangers, candle stands, jewelry box, and the bells. The second technique is the iron smithy technique, which is practiced comparatively by lesser number of tribes. In this technique, The iron is heated up and then beaten continuously until it obtains a particular form of an object. The Agaria and the Lohar tribes of Chhattisgarh practice this technique. This technique is used to make showpieces items like ornaments and lamps. The next type of tribal craft is the tribal textiles. The tribes of India have designed various types of handlooms by making several drawings which are inspired by their history and culture. Several designs on their handlooms depict their mythology and legends. There is a wide range of material, color, texture which is tribe specific. One can see the extent of creativity that is reflected from the tribal textiles. The tribes of Northeast India weave a variety of shawls, blankets, wraps, and many other garments which are very beautiful and colorful. In Andhra Pradesh, the tribes add shells and mirrors to the fabric to make them look beautiful, and they also make mats and cushions and pillow covers out of these, while embroidery is one of the characteristic of the Todas in Nilgiris of Tamil Nadu. A variety of garments and other handlooms are prepared by the tribal people, which include the shawls, saris, cushion covers, mekhla chandar and the dupattas. Various shawls and stoles are made by the tribes of Himachal Pradesh. That is the Bodh tribe and Kinnauri tribe from this state. They make very beautiful shawls. The Dongriya Korn girls also make shawls with beautiful embroideries. The Naga shawl made by various tribes of Nagaland are also very pretty. The next in the tribal textiles are the saris. Beautiful plain red colored cotton saris are worn by women of Mahar, Gond, Maria, Garwa and the Bhatra tribes. Cushion covers. The Banjara tribes of Andhra Pradesh make cushion covers with floral patchwork on them, while the Lambanis of Karnataka make silk cushion covers with mirror work and embroidery on it. The Mekhla Chadar is a traditional Assamese dress which is worn by the women. It comprises of two pieces. One is the Mekhla that is draped around the lower half of the body, and the another portion of this dress is called the Chandar, which is a piece of cloth worn on the upper portion of the body. It is prepared by the Mishi tribe of Assam. The dupattas. The tribal dupattas are mainly made up of cotton or silk. The Panika tribe make cotton hand-spun dupattas which are colored using vegetable dyes. Usually the patterns of birds and butterflies are designed onto these dupattas. The Gond tribe of Chhattisgarh make tussar silk dupattas. The next in this are the tribal paintings. Tribal paintings are a mirror of the tribal expression which reflect their creativity as well as their simplicity. Many tribes use their paintings to decorate their homes and as a welcome note on their doors and floors. Tribal paintings are an expression of their daily livelihood and their interaction with the nature. India is a land of diversity where every place differs in its culture, climate, and heritage from the other, so differ the tribal communities. Some of the famous tribal paintings of India are the Worli paintings, Gond paintings, Pithora paintings, and palm leaf paintings. The Worli paintings or the Worli folk paintings are made by the Worli tribe of Maharashtra. And these paintings are usually made inside the huts on a background which is coated with cow dung or mud, then either with the chalk powder or rice powder they use to make the design on the dark colored background. A bamboo stick sharpened at one end is used to make these designs. And the major theme of the Worli paintings is harvesting and wedding. Generally, nature is depicted in these paintings. The next are the Gond paintings, which is made by the Gond tribe. Gond tribe is the largest tribe of central India and is distributed in Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Orissa and Maharashtra. The people of this tribe make beautiful paintings which are very colorful. And these paintings depict various cultural and traditional rituals of this tribe. The paintings are mainly designed with figures of birds and flora. These paintings are made on various occasions with the help of cow dung, leaves, sap, and other natural ingredients. Various gods and goddesses are also depicted in gaunt paintings. These paintings are mainly drawn by joining lines and dots, which give the picture an entirely different look. Various gaunt artists have become famous on national level and make these traditional paintings in canvas. The Pithora paintings, which are made by the Bhils of Madhya Pradesh and Rathwas of Gujarat. In these paintings, marriage is the main themes and various marriage processions are depicted. Pithora paintings are of great ritual significance and painting is drawn by performing certain rituals. There are Pithora painters in some communities who draw these on the walls of the houses. And these paintings also have certain myths associated with them. These are basically drawn using leaf extracts, lamp back, and other natural products. The Bhils of Madhya Pradesh make these paintings by first coating the walls with cow dung, and horses are a major component of these paintings. Palm leaf paintings. The palm leaf paintings are one of the ancient paintings of Odisha. The Sowra tribe of Odisha makes paintings on palm leaves, silk and also on the cloths. Various stories, myths and gods and goddesses are depicted in these paintings. The next in the category of the type of tribal crafts is the tribal jewelry. In any society, jewelry and other ornaments are a symbol of status, wealth and prosperity. But in tribal societies, jewelry has religious and other significance also. A person with a higher social status is usually adorned with heavy ornaments. For example, among the Naga tribes of Nagaland, the long tail feathers of a hornbill are an important part of their ritual dress. The tribal jewelry and ornaments have symbolic value and usually are a symbol of power. Tribal communities have kept the original designs preserved till date. The tribal jewelry are made up of raw material easily available to tribal people, for example, the wood, clay, shells, etc. And these jewelry products are not only attractive, but also hold a uniqueness in itself. Some of the jewelry and ornaments made by the tribal people are bison horn head dresses, necklaces made up of silver, gold, and other crude materials. The Lambadi tribal women wear ornaments like necklaces, anklets, forehead belts made up from silver. The cane and bamboo products are another type of tribal crafts. As we know, human beings have an intricate relationship with plants and we are dependent on plants for many purposes, be it food, shelter, medicine or any other product. Tribal communities depend largely on plants. And they, because of living in close proximity with various plants, have identified and used different parts of plant for different purposes. For example, the cocoa palm is used to make spears, knives, canoes, fuel, mats, baskets and hats, etc. The northeastern states of India is rich in cane and bamboos, and the tribal communities living in close association with the forest have been utilizing it as a raw material for making many daily use products. The tribal communities of northeast region have utilized the cane and bamboo to every possible extent and also have developed techniques which are unique to their own communities. There is a varied range of bamboo and cane products found among various states of Northeast region. Bamboo baskets are a common product which can be seen with every Northeastern tribal people. The baskets are made according to various purposes in different sizes and different shapes. Conical carrying baskets are common to every household. They are also known as akhi and akha. The flattened cylindrical baskets are used for storing rice beer. The flat-bottomed big baskets are used for storing grains to it. The mesoconical bamboo baskets are used by women for carrying purposes. These baskets are known as paikwang. The angami bamboo baskets, known as kofi, are a beautiful craft of Mizoram. It has its own significance and is given to the daughter at the time of their marriage. In different types of baskets, the bamboo is used in a different form. Several patterns are made while making these baskets, which are unique in itself. Apart from the various types of baskets, the tribal people of Northeast region make other utilitarian products from cane and bamboo, like cane mats, storage vessels, hats, fishing equipments, etc. Apart from the tribes of Northeastern region, the Gadaba and Gonds of Chhattisgarh make flutes from bamboo shoots, which are used for musical purpose and to control the herds as well. The next form of tribal craft is the pottery. Apart from the already mentioned crafts, certain tribes make their own pottery by a technique which is unique to their community. The pottery includes vessels and utensils which are used for many purposes. The Longpi property is one of the famous tribal craft and is practiced by the Thangkul Naga tribe of Manipur. This pottery is a status symbol among this tribe, as only rich people can afford to have it. It is used at special occasions like marriage, festivals and feasts. The Longpi pottery basically got its name from the name of the village where it is practiced. This specific type of pottery is made from the mixture of weathered rock and black serpentine stone. The mixture or the clay thus formed is then placed on a flat surface and the desired shape is given by hands. The structure thus formed is left for drying. Once it is dried, it is put into a furnace for heating, and the next step is rubbing and polishing of the potteries, which are done by local plant leaves known as the Chiron Na. The polishing and rubbing is done before the temperature drops down, and after this, the final pottery is formed, which is ready to be used. Let's discuss the role of government and NGOs in promoting tribal crafts. The government of India has always tried to uplift the tribes of the country by various means. Many efforts have been made to accelerate the tribal economic development by promoting their art and craft. The crafts made by tribal people are unique in their look, components and structure. People like them because of their uniqueness and are in great demand these days. So, under the Ministry of Tribal Affairs, Government of India, an organization named as Tribal Cooperative Marketing Development Federation of India Limited, established in 1987, and it works particularly for the development of tribal art and craft. The organization has set up various shops all across the nation where various tribal products are displayed for selling. And these shops have been given the name of Tribes India. Apart from the government initiatives to preserve and promote the tribal arts and crafts, there are many non-governmental organizations which are working in this context. NGOs collect the products from tribal people and put stalls at various places all across the nation to sell these products. The motive behind all this is not just to uplift the tribal economic development, but all these actions help tribal communities to come forward and spread their art and craft at domestic as well as at the national level. So students, let us summarize this module. The tribes constitute around 8% of the total population of nation and spread over different geographical areas. The large portion of the tribal population is inhabited in the central and northeastern areas of India. In central India, the tribes are distributed mainly in the states of Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Gujarat, Maharashtra and Rajasthan. In northeastern India, the tribal areas are situated in the states of Assam, Mizoram, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Tripura, Manipur, Sikkim and Arunachal Pradesh. Tribal crafts include any handmade artifact prepared by tribal people. These products are generally made by raw material which is procured from the nearby forest or natural resources. In the states of Chhattisgarh, Bihar, Odisha and West Bengal are famous for their metal crafts. The metal products produced in these regions of nation come under the bell metal art or the Dhokra art. The tribes of India have designed various types of handlooms by making several drawings which are inspired by their history and culture and are prepared with beautiful colors which are generally prepared using natural ingredients. Tribal paintings are a mirror of the tribal expression, which reflect their creativity as well as their simplicity. The Worli painting, Gond painting, Pithora painting, and palm leaf painting are some of the examples of very famous tribal paintings of India. Tribal jewelry is a symbol of their status and power. Various ornaments like necklaces, wristbands, anklets, etc. are prepared using raw material which is available in their surroundings. Now, the tribes living in forests, especially near the cane and bamboo forest, make full use of these materials and prepare enormous number of their daily use products, which includes baskets of various shapes and sizes, hats and vessels, etc. Tribal people make beautiful pottery also, and the Longpi pottery from Manipur is very famous, and very rich tribal people occupy this pottery. The government of India has been trying to promote these tribal arts and crafts in national and global markets so that the tribal economy can be fastened. Several NGOs are also working in this light. Thank you.